Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install latest version of Python, that is Python version 3.13.6 on a Windows operating system. So first you need to go to favorite browser and to type over here Python download. Hit enter. So that will show you this python.org. So just simply click on this download Python and it's going to redirect to the official site of Python. So this Python link I'm going to provide right in your channel description. Once when you are here, you will see the latest version of Python, that is version 13.6, is available to download. So to click on this download button for Windows, if you are using Linux or Mac OS, you can always change to all these different links. For Windows, just simply click on this download button and here is our Python rightly downloaded over here. So just simply click on this installer. That's going to open this install Python 3.13.6 installation wizard. So let's minimize your browser and here select both these two options. This is very important. You need to select this add python.txt to path and click on custom installation. So that's going to open these optional features. Here you need to keep everything as default and click on next. Here under advanced options, you need to select the very first one, that is install Python 3.13 for all users. And then you need to keep everything as default and click on install. So that's going to ask you for administrative privileges, click on yes, and our Python installation is rightly begun. So it's going to take a couple of minutes. So by the time it gets installed, since we are talking about Python, I'll recommend to follow this cool Python project playlist. So all these videos are completely free, so you'll be able to learn how to create your very own rock, paper, scissor game, how to deploy any Python project to some server, that to completely free. You'll be able to create your very own QR code, that too using Python. So all these videos are completely free and detailed source code that I have showed you on these videos are also available for completely free on our geekyscape.com website. So for example, this game that I have created, this rock paper scissor game, you'll be able to see this detailed source code, so you can copy it, you can paste it, and you can create your very own this rock paper scissor game. And you can also list all these projects to your resume. That's going to only help you to land to your dream job. So do check out all these different Python projects that I have created on our channel. Here, let's wait for a few more seconds. So we'll come back. So now you can clearly see that our Python is rightly installed. So you can just simply click on close. So now if you go to search and just simply type cmd, so that will show you command prompt over here. So just click on command prompt. And here if you just simply type Python and hit enter, you are going to get this type of prompt. So that means our Python version 3.13.6 is rightly installed. So you can print Hello World program here as well. So you can print something like hello and hit enter. You are going to get this type of output. Similarly, you can also open your Python idle shell. So again, go to search and type idle. That will show you this idle. Open that. And our Python idle shell is rightly opened. So here if you just simply type print hello, you are going to get that similar type of prompt. You can also create a new file and write some program. So let's assign a couple of values, so like a equal to 8 and let's say b equal to 6, and let's print summation of these two numbers, so a plus b. So you know, write this much and go to file and click on save as. So let's save this file on our desktop as sum.py. Just write this much and go to run and click on run module. We are going to get the output coming on our console, right? So 8 plus 6, that is 14, a plus b, that is properly coming on our console. See, this way I can easily install latest version of Python and can start working on your Python projects. I highly recommend you to install PyCharm. So once you have PyCharm up and running, so you can follow this PyCharm unified video. So once you have PyCharm up and running, you are good to run any Python projects that I have showed you on all these videos. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.